friends, in this video we are going to see open circuit and short circuit test on a transformer in order to find out equivalent circuit diagram. See, it's very difficult in a transformer to get value of resistance and leakage reactance by measuring. So some tests are there which you can perform outside a transformer and then predict what would be the parameters of transformer. And those tests are nothing but open circuit and short circuit test. So let's discuss open circuit test first. I will draw the setup first. So here we have this AC supply. This is auto transformer. This is voltmeter, ammeter, and wattmeter. Normally we perform open circuit test on low voltage side, keeping high voltage side open circuit. So I will write, first point is OC test is performed on low voltage side, or you can say low voltage winding, keeping high voltage winding open circuited. Why we are doing this? It's an open circuit test, so the current that is measured by this ammeter will be very less. So if KVA rating of a transformer is same from primary as well as secondary side, so very less current you are getting if you are applying voltage to the high voltage side. Take an example, if my KVA is say 1 KVA and low voltage side is 100 volt and high voltage is let's say 10,000. So thing is that if I perform test on high voltage side, very very low current you will get, which we cannot measure through the ammeter. And secondly, a very high voltage you are applying, again that high voltage cannot be measured by this voltmeter. So because of the restriction on meters, we are not performing open circuit test on high voltage side. Otherwise it's okay, absolutely it will give same results, but because of the restrictions on meters we perform open circuit test on low voltage winding. Now as we have discussed, this current measured by ammeter is I0. So I will list out all the voltage, current and wattage. So V0 voltage it will measure, we will call this as no load primary voltage. Obviously it will be a rated voltage for low voltage side. I0 is no load primary current and W0 will be the power measured by this wattmeter, which we call as no load losses, which are nothing but core losses. I0 is a no load primary current which will be very very low. If the current is having a very low value, obviously its square will be even lesser, hence copper losses happening in the primary winding will be very less. Hence, we can say whatever the power that it will measure will be core losses only. Now, what are the observations we can make from this? Let's discuss that. So, from OC test, we got V0, I0 and W0. W0 is V0, I0 cos phi 0. From this, I can get cos phi 0. From this, I will get phi, or you can say phi 0. No load, power factor angle. Phi 0 is the no load power factor angle. Now, what is the need of this? I will explain this with the help of one simple circuit and a phasor diagram. So, the circuit is like this. So, in the circuit, I am having parallel combination of one resistance and inductance. Resistance is called as core loss resistance RC, and inductance, its reactance is magnetizing reactance XM, and current carrying by RC is core loss component of I0, and current carrying by XM is I mu, magnetizing component of I0, and here it will be no load voltage V0. So, the objective of OC test, get the value of RC and XM. So, from this, I can draw a phasor diagram. Phasor diagram will be like this. I have two currents. One is responsible for flux creation. So, I mu will come in phase with this flux phi. I mu is a current carrying by this XM, and voltage across XM is V0. So, for pure inductor, voltage leads current by 90 degree. And same voltage is across this RC, where current is IC in phase with this. And phasor addition of IC and I mu is no load primary current I0. And phi 0 is the angle between V0 and I0. From this, what I can say, IC is nothing but I0 cos phi 0, and I mu is I0 sin phi 0. If you got these two values, we can get RC, which also called as no load resistance R0 V0 divided by IC. So, straight away we are getting core loss resistance. One of the important part of equivalent circuit. Similarly, magnetizing reactance XM, also called as no load reactance X0, equal to V0 upon I mu. This is the outcome of OC test, getting these two parameters RC and XM, and whatever the power measured by wattmeter will be nothing but core losses in a transformer. Let's go to second test, that is short circuit test. I will first draw setup for short circuit test. Here we have AC supply. For controlling it, we have auto transformer. Ammeter, and we have wattmeter. All meters we are connecting at high voltage side, meaning we are performing short circuit test on high voltage side, keeping or short circuiting low voltage winding. So normally short circuit test is performed on high voltage winding. Short circuiting low voltage winding. Why so? Again, it is because of the restriction of this ammeter. If you perform a test on a low voltage side, very high current is going to flow, which cannot be measured by the ammeter that we are having. That is the only reason. Otherwise, you can perform both the tests on same winding, no problem. Results that you will obtain is absolutely same. So short circuit test is performed on high voltage winding, and the readings we are getting are this: VSC, short circuit voltage, ISC, short circuit current. It is comparable with the full load current. And WSC short circuit losses, or you can say short circuit power. Now this VSC is very low compared to rated voltage. If voltage is very low, obviously the losses depends on voltage will also be less. Losses which depends on voltage are core losses. Hence, this wattmeter will not measure core losses, or even if it is measuring, it will be very less compared to copper losses. Why copper losses will be more over here? Because of this short circuit current, which is comparable with full load current. So significant amount of current is flowing through the windings, hence WSC are nothing but copper losses. So I can summarize: wattmeter will read copper losses because of high current passing through winding, and voltage is very low, hence core losses cannot be recorded. Now, what are the observations we can make from the short circuit test? We got three readings: VSC, ISC and WSC. Power losses here are I square R losses, and this resistance could be anything, either a primary equivalent resistor or a secondary equivalent resistor, depends upon which side is high voltage, low voltage. Suppose I am considering a transformer, which is step up transformer. So in this case, what I am saying here, it will be R2E. That means high voltage winding is secondary. So therefore R2E, it's not necessary that all the time it should be R2E. It could be R1E, depends upon which side is primary and secondary. Now from this, I can get R2E equal to WSC upon ISC square. So one of the parameter I obtain, voltage and current are known to me, I can get impedance. So it is VSC upon ISC. From the resistance and impedance, I can get reactance. So reactance equal to root of impedance square minus resistance square. So the outcome of this test is getting winding parameters referred to one side. So if I consider both the tests together, what actually we have achieved? Actually, we are getting equivalent circuit diagram of a transformer. I am considering a step up transformer. So low voltage side is a primary side, and we perform OC test over there, and we got two parameters. So the parameters are RC and XM. So primary side voltage is V1. This is low voltage side of a transformer. I perform short circuit test on high voltage side, that is a secondary, and the parameters that I obtain are R2E and X2E. And here secondary side voltage is V2. So this is a equivalent circuit diagram of a transformer that we obtain from OCSC test. You can refer this side parameter, that means low voltage side parameter, to high voltage side, or high voltage side parameter to low voltage side, having only one circuit. We have already discussed this at the time of studying equivalent circuit diagram of a transformer referred to primary or referred to secondary. So once you got this, you can transform from LV to HV or HV to LV based upon turns ratio or EMF ratio. So from the OCSC test of transformer, we got equivalent circuit diagram, and secondly, core losses that we obtained through OC test, and we can get copper losses also, but that won't be at full load, but obviously at some fractional load. So from the short circuit test, we will obtain copper losses in a transformer also. What is the use of all this? Getting this, we can find out transformer specification. That means we can obtain efficiency and voltage regulation of transformer. So knowing equivalent circuit diagram of a transformer is very much essential. Thank you.